Hello, and welcome, Ryan from One Republic. Hello, how are you?
Good, how are you doing?
Now let's talk about your breakthrough single, Apologise. You got your mate Timbo on it. It's a collaboration.
Yeah.
Big tune. Now he's pretty big in all senses of the word.
Yeah.
Nelly Furtado, Madonna, Justin.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a sweet deal to get him on board.
What Timbaland did was instead of it just breaking in the States, mm-hmm. he took it every country at the same time. It went number one like everywhere.
Did you get mates rates?
Do I get mates
rates? Yeah, because I heard he charges something ridiculous, like what, like £300,000 per track.
Not pounds, but he used to get
more than Dr. Dre.
He used to get he's the most expensive producer in the world. He'd get as much as £250.
Whoa!
I've seen him.
£250.
Yeah,
or
I mean £250,000.
Oh, yeah.
£250,000.
I'll take 10.
Exactly, but for us, Apologize was free. So.
Oh sweet!
Yeah.
Freebie. It's too late to apologize. After the success of Apologise, were you a bit worried about like going it without the big man with Stop and Stare?
I think this song's great, and I thought, man, you know, if this song can't connect without Tim, then I guess Apologise will be it. But we really felt that it would connect, so thankfully it is.
Now the video is a bit on the weird side, a bit freaky: a burning TV, empty grave, pregnant woman, and a town full of oddballs. What's it all about?
We needed to get away from the Timbaland pop, super pop, mm-hmm. Apologize kind of thing, and kind of swing it back towards more us. Basically, what it means is the pregnant woman mm-hmm. represents birth and life, and the grave represents death, and all the people standing outside the window looking in represent all these people from different walks of life and all the choices you could make between life and death. Stop.
Let's talk about your album, Dreaming Out Loud.
It's kind of like, we had a song called Dreaming Out Loud that for some reason didn't make the album. But then we realized for the last 4 years as a band, we'd been talking about all the things that we hoped would happen.
Mm-hmm.
And just like, man, it would be great to tour Europe one day. It'd be great to do this. It'd be great to actually have, you know, a song actually come out after all these record labels and whatever. And we realized that kind of what we were doing the whole time was dreaming out loud.
Now, what musical treats and delights can we expect from this album?
If you like Stop and Stare and Apologize, I really think you'll love the album. There's a lot more where that came from. The third single is actually our favorite song. We like it even more than Stop and Stare, so.
Thank you very much for coming in. Good luck with it all. It's already going brilliantly from what I can see. So thank you very much, Robert Public. Cheers, Ryan.
Thanks for having me.
And with that, once again, another freshly